Hey guys, let's look at this last section dealing with the fourth type of hydrocarbon, aromatic hydrocarbons. So here we're going to say aromatic compounds have a benzene ring in common. That's their major feature. And remember, a benzene ring is C6H6, because remember, every corner and edge is a carbon, which I've displayed here. Now, what we need to realize here is that you can draw it a bunch of different ways. We're going to say here that maybe the double bond is here, here, and here. Now, we're going to say that these double bonds overlap, or they're alternating actually. Alternate would be a more correct term for them. So these double bonds alternate. They go double bond, single bond, double bond. We're going to say that alternating double and single bonds, they actually have a name in organic. It's called conjugation. And here's the thing about conjugation. If you can draw them alternating, that means you can draw them different ways. So we can draw the double bonds in that orientation, or maybe the double bonds go this way. Okay, so both are possible structures. And because we are just moving around double bonds or moving around electrons, we're going to say these two initial drawings represent the resonance structures of benzene. Now, here's the thing. Resonance structures are imaginary. They're not real. The real structure is called the resonance hybrid. It is basically a composite of both of these structures on top of each other. So basically think of it as they both have blueprints to the inside of a building. One alone doesn't have all the information you need. So what happens here is you take one blueprint and you put the other one on top. And the composite is them lining up everything on top of each other, and then you'll get the complete picture of the building itself. That complete picture represents my resonance hybrid. Now here's the thing, anywhere a double bond has been, we'll get a dotted line. So there was a double bond here, so this is gonna get a dotted line. There's a double bond here, so this is gonna get a dotted line. Double bond here, so it's gonna get a dotted line. So basically anywhere a double bond has been is gonna get a dotted line. So that represents my resonance hybrid. Now, you may eventually see benzene written like this. Not like those two resonance structures, but instead you'll see a circle. That circle represents the resonance hybrid. Again, why is it a circle? Because the double bonds have been everywhere inside of that compound based on those two resonance structures. So we just use a circle to show this. Okay, so me drawing these dotted lines where double bonds have been is basically me giving you the groundwork to draw this at the end. So this also represents the resonance hybrid. They're both the same exact structure. Now, here, benzenes can be found in everyday compounds from the gasoline that we drive, fossil fuels, from oil rigs. There's a lot of places that you'll find benzene. Even when we're breaking down fossil fuels and burning them, some of the byproducts are benzene. And we're gonna say here, even in some vital medications that people use every day, you can find benzene involved. Here, for example, this molecule, huge molecule, I've highlighted in red the benzene ring. So right here's one benzene, here's another benzene, and here's a third benzene. This is an incredibly important drug. This is Lipitor. For those people with high cholesterol, they use Lipitor to help control that. And so it controls your cholesterol, controls the fat within your body. So everyday things from the fossil fuels that we use to drive machines around this world, to even Lipitor that people get from the counter at the pharmacy, all of them have benzene involved. Benzene is an incredibly versatile compound. It's incredibly stable. That's why you find it in a lot of different things. And if you want to take organic 2 eventually, you're going to realize that when you get to organic 2, there are actually a few chapters entirely devoted to just benzene and compounds just like benzene. Aromatic compounds. They're incredibly important in synthesis of a lot of other things, so that's why so much detail is paid attention to them. But for right now, just remember the basics in terms of it. It's C6H6, has resonance structures, but the resonance hybrid is the better example of what it looks like. Later on, we'll go over some of the reactions that benzenes commonly do, but nothing too extravagant. Again, we're holding on a lot until you get to organic 2.